Welcome to Kubernetes Tutorial, and this video is called Kubernetes Internal. We're gonna talk about the internal processes of Kubernetes in overview. So this is the complete Kubernetes. You've got a master, you've got a node, and we've got two nodes here, and you've got the overlay or the networking, and we've got the Docker hub. So let's go into the master. The master is a node with specials. So we'll go in the node in the next slide, but Kubernetes has a control plane. In the center of that control plane, you've got an API server. Supporting this API server, you've got an etcd. This is a database which has the complete book of Kubernetes. So it has everything Kubernetes is. So it has the information of the pods, information of the controller manager, information of the scheduler, information of the nodes. So this is your master database. From your master database, we'll go to the scheduler. This scheduler is the process that starts up or gives the command to the node to start up a pod. Also, a scheduler looks at the annotations and the tolerances of your deployment to start up the pod on your specific node. The scheduler sends a command to a node with the information of the database. So the controller manager. The controller manager is the process that controls your pods. So it checks if your pods are still alive. And when they're not alive, it will send a message to the scheduler, and the scheduler will terminate the pod and start the pod again. So the controller manager is an important process. These four are the control plane, and you've got one special, and that's kubeDNS. It's just a normal DNS server, but it has all the information of all pods. So it's got IP and pod name, and that's build up of the Kubernetes cluster name and the namespace and the deployment and the pod name. It also has information about the services and everything which has an IP address. So we'll go to the node now. A node has Docker running, has a kubelet running, and a kubeproxy. These three processes are a node. So first, Docker is the normal Docker. When you do yum install Docker, it's the normal Docker process, your container. You can use different container methodologies like Rocket, Zero, but in this example, we use Docker. The kubelet is the main process that runs the node. It's the node software. The kubeproxy is your connection to the outside world. It will fill your IP tables with the right rules to get to the pod. it will create your tunnels and so on. So kubeproxy outside world. So the node runs pods. A pod can consist of one or two or three or four containers, and a pod has an IP address. It's a unique IP address based on the pod subnet of this node. So every node has its own pod subnet. This is all automatically given. So there's a custom bridge and a CNI, and container network interface. Commonly we use a flannel or a calico. We use flannel for simple clusters and calico for bigger clusters. You've got much more CNIs out there, but they're more difficult and have more options and they fail more. In my experience, Calico is the best one. So this is a node. When nodes are communicating with each other, they have an IP address, but this is on the underlying network. In the underlying network, you've got an overlay tunnel which pods can communicate through. So you've got a tunnel, and that's different than the underlying network. So if you look at the bigger picture, this pod can communicate through the tunnel with this pod on the different node. If you run a pod, so kubelet gives the command to the Docker, and the Docker pulls the Docker from the Docker hub or your own registry. So now this is the complete working of Kubernetes internally. But now you have to send commands. We can use Kubernetes dashboard for that, or the kubectl. In a later video, I will explain Kubernetes dashboard and I will explain kubectl in depth. Thank you very much. There's more to come. Subscribe for my channel. If you subscribe, I will make more videos. Thank you very much.